Hello and welcome back to Module 2. This is the last part of Module 2. We're in Section 3, which is focusing on content and copyright. And in this section, we're going to be having a think about digital plagiarism. Now, digital plagiarism is increasingly a problem in our schools because young people think they can just copy and paste stuff from the internet and hand it in as if they're their own. Obviously, the lessons that we learned from the last video on copyright are really, really important here. And in this short video, I'm going to introduce you into one or two tools which you can use with your students so that they can see that it's really easy for you as a teacher to find out if they've been plagiarizing digital content. There are a number of online digital plagiarism checkers that are available. Some of them are free, some of them are paid for, and some of them have got a subscription service. The three that I'm going to introduce you to here are all free to use, but you do need to subscribe to one of them. The first one that I've used is one that's called Plagiarism Checker. It comes from smallsearchengineoptimizationtools.com. All you do is you cut and paste the information into it and you check whether it's unique. It does a Google search, it searches other websites as well to see if there's any duplication with other content on the web. Plagiarism.check does a very, very similar thing, although the advantage of this is that you can do a quick search, or you can do a deep search using a number of other different types of pages. It's also got some other advanced search options. Plagiarama.net, again, is very, very effective. This is a subscription-based service. It will search against Google. It will search against Yahoo. The nice thing about this website is you can also upload a document to it, as well as just cutting and pasting information in from the web in order for it to do a file search. So offering something there that perhaps the other two sites that I mentioned don't do. It's important to remember, of course, it's not just text that people are looking for. Increasingly now, young people are also uploading images as well, which might not be their own, and they need to be correctly attributed. TinEye.com is reverse image search. You can upload an image to there, and it will cross-check it to other images on the web to see where it comes from. A really, really useful tool, not just in digital plagiarism, but also in internet safety and responsible use. And the last website that I want to quickly mention is Google Alerts. I know that we've talked a little bit about it already, but again, very, very useful in terms of tracking digital plagiarism and keeping an eye on things to see if things have been updated. If you're really interested in this sort of thing, you might want to check out plagiarismtoday.com. Now, plagiarismtoday.com is a website all about plagiarism, but in particular, it concentrates on digital plagiarism. Well worth a look and having a look at some of the information that's available, and also subscribing to their podcast if you're interested in that sort of thing. So there we are, we're at the end of Module 2. And in Module 2, we've mainly been focusing on search and search engine optimization, and more recently, digital copyright and digital plagiarism. Hope you've enjoyed this module. If you go onto the online forum now, there'll be a little quiz for you to complete and also a little task to do. And after that, you'll get a digital badge for this module. We'll also start to get you in the mindset of thinking about your final assignment, which will be in a few weeks' time. Once again, I hope you've enjoyed Module 2. I've certainly enjoyed giving you some of this information, and I've enjoyed the discussions that we've been having online as well. I look forward to seeing you in Module 3, when we're going to be thinking about how can we use digital tools for students to create content. I'll see you there.